Hey guys, Maxi709 here, and today we are talking about Pokemon Go. Now, if you're still there and you're thinking, what is Pokemon Go? It's an augmented reality Pokemon game. If you've never heard of it, go check it out. It's amazing. Pokemon Go it's not even released worldwide yet, and it has so far become one of the biggest gaming apps currently going, with millions and millions of players all choosing to play it at the same time. It's created server issues, etc. It's even become one of the largest grossing gaming apps, even to the point where it's actually earning more per day than sort of Candy Crush and Clash of Clans, sort of like the big gaming apps. Pokemon Go has got to the point where it's earning a few million dollars per day. It's probably, if not already, claim back all the development costs, which are apparently in the 30 million zone. It's very near going to have already gained all that back within a week of being released. It's not, like I said, it's not even released worldwide. It is predominantly Australia and America. Even Canada hasn't got it yet, but North America has. You know, for this, it was such a huge, huge thing for Nintendo and Pokemon and Niantic, which is the development team behind it. Now, with such a huge fan base and players, and soon to be even more players once it is released worldwide, there's obviously a huge issue of keeping everyone happy. The main issue so far has been server issues. Those will no doubt get fixed, especially with the money that the game is making. They can afford to buy a few more servers, and I'm sure they will. The biggest thing is keeping everyone happy for the long run. There's been plenty of gaming apps that have come up that have become hugely successful, hugely popular, and then they slowly just die off because nothing really happens with them. There's no further improvements, no further levels, game features, etc. added. And Pokemon Go have got to go against, you know, got to prove themselves for the long run. In recent interviews, there has been talk about how they're going to add trading as one of the main features. Obviously, this would add a lot to the game, but obviously, it depends how they do it. Obviously, the game relies heavily on teamwork, and the idea is you get off your boat, you get out of the house, go with a few mates, you take all gyms, and go out and catch Pokemon in real life. That's the idea. You go out, you're all part of the same team, big up Team Mystic, you're all part of a big team, and you go out, take over gyms, and basically dominate your local area. That's the main, very, very rough idea. Now, for trading, it depends how they do it. If they do trading as you can only trade with people who are close by, then I think they might have a bit of a problem, because there's plenty of people who either don't know someone else who plays the game yet, or don't know someone else who plays the game who's on the same team, if they limit the trading between teams. There's also people who are very rural, and have to travel quite far just to get to a local Pokestop, never mind actually like gyms, etc. That's a good place to get booked. So, luckily for me, I live like down the road from town. And even though I live in a fairly small town, there's quite a few Pokestops and there's even a couple of gyms in the town centre sort of area. So, for me, it's not too bad, but obviously, there are others that have to go by car with the local place. So, trading could be a huge, huge improvement. It's obviously, it's more obvious when you start. Pokemon, the traditional Pokemon games, all are trading. So to add it to Pokemon Go, it seems the obvious choice. But like I said, all depends how they do it. If they do it so they can trade with anyone across the world, I think that would be amazing. That would be great, just because it limits that. It stops those people that are by themselves playing the game from being stuck, not being able to trade. The main idea of trading. because of the sheer amount of players that's already on the game, with millions and millions of players already, that the teams will effectively have enough players for everyone to trade happily on those teams. There's also talk in this interview that they're going to add in more functionality to the gyms. I think that's pretty good. And I think that's why I think they're probably just postponing it until they've got a lot more servers that could run the game. Which, you know, smart, I suppose. There's no point releasing the game worldwide officially. Production. Just for everyone to download it and then get really angry and really annoyed that they can't play the game because it's so much easier. So I think it's playing safe. The people who really want to play the game, like I said, are going to play the game. There is hints of possibly getting bans from doing it this way, but I think with it, quite frankly, it's probably a few million people who are doing it this way. I think it would be very harsh and kind of silly and a bit backwards for 90 to then block and ban these users, whether it's block their device or the actual account. It would be a bit better. Successful it is, and I think it will allow other games allow other games to release in a similar format, such as Mario.